Hey guys, Henning and Morten from FlippedNormals here. In this video, we're going to be showing you some really nice tips and tricks in Substance Painter, which you probably didn't know. Before we get into that though, make sure to subscribe and hit the notification button to get notified every time we put out a new video. So the very first thing we're going to be looking at is a new feature in Painter, which is awesome. It is the ability to now display real-time displacement maps in the viewport. How exciting.
Yeah, that's pretty exciting, actually.
It's very exciting. We find this under the shader settings, and now we have a new little tab here called displacement tessellation. So we just have a quick height map here. This is just a fill layer with a displacement, a grunge map plugged into it. So the first thing we can do is we can change the scale of it.
So sick.
What we can see now is, you know, obviously just taking the polygons which are there, and it just displaces them. It just takes one point and just moves it out, which isn't very impressive. Where it gets very impressive is that we can change the subdivision mode. What's the subdivision mode and count? So now we can subdivide this a few times. And now you can see that this actually changes and actually subdivides it.
I didn't know you could have decimals in subdivision. Like you can subdivide it 4.19 times.
Yeah, I don't know how that works. But the cool thing is, now we get really, really nicely subdivided models directly in the viewport. This has two modes. It has the uniform mode and it has edge length, which, you know,
edge length
is what it's doing.
Yeah, edge length, I think, is so you can define the quality between the edge length. Uniform is just like uniforms everything equally.
Yeah, I think edge length is like the shortest edge.
Yeah, yeah.
So you can see the higher the value, it's 125 out of 1.
So it's probably more adaptive. Yeah. Like where it needs more subdivision, it'll subdivide, I think. I think that's how it works.
I think that's how it works. Regardless, this is pretty cool.
Yeah. So now you can actually do fur inside of
Substance Painter. Yeah, exactly. So regardless of you using iRay or just the viewport, this works really well. The reason I'm so excited about this is because this gives you a real approximation of what something is going to look like. When you're texturing, it's so important that stuff is looking the way it actually looks.
Yeah.
And without this, you're just kind of, you know, trying some stuff out. So that's really cool. Another cool thing, which they very recently added, is if you want to make a new fill layer and you only want to have, let's say, metal enabled, what you'd have to do is you got to click, 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 and then set it to metal, and it becomes super shiny, because that's what Painter does. Now what you can do, you can simply alt-click on the channel you want. This is such a nice little time saver, and it's a really welcome improvement. So you just make another one. This is going to be roughness. Now this is only roughness. Another one, this is only color, and now this is only color.
So, you know, over the course of a year, maybe you save a few minutes, but imagine over the course of your entire career.
Yeah, exactly.
That's going to be, you know, such a big change.
And also just because you keep clicking the time. This was just introduced, and it didn't exist when we did our introduction to Painter.
Yeah.
And we're doing that, it was click.
So obviously our introduction to Painter is completely outdated now.
Completely out of date, fortunately. Then another one is if you have different texture sets. Now, this is something which I use all the time and you may not know about. If you hold Control, Alt, right mouse button, you can now switch between the texture sets, which means that this list here is kind of useless for the majority of the time because you're simply going to do this.
Yeah.
I see a lot of people actually going all the way up and they have a huge list of things. It's really not an issue. Control, Alt, right mouse button.
Now, this is something like not only will it speed everything up, I feel like it's just a lot more manageable, especially if you have a lot of texture sets. Even though it's nicely named and everything, sometimes it can be a bit hard to find.
Yeah, exactly. It's like similar to selecting subtools and sabers. Just alt-click on it and
exactly.
You have it. The next one is something I discovered quite by accident, and that is that the color picker responds to anything in the UI, and not just in Painter, but anything in Windows.
Yeah, that actually blew my mind.
So let's move this guy down here a little, and let's open up an image. So let's say you want to color pick from this picture here, from our streetwear outfit in Substance, in Marvelous Designer.
Marvelous.
So many designers. So now you want the color here to be the hair color. Now you just click the color, you pick the color, and now it picks whatever color you want. The cool thing about this works with anything in the UI. So if you want the nice blueness of the button, or, you know, zebras in the background, you know, whatever it might be, you can just pick anything you desire in the entire interface. We use this specifically for the hand painting human textures in Substance Painter, where we have a bunch of swatches out here. So instead of just guesstimating some colors, we just have some pre-made swatches, click them, and then you get them in.
Yeah, it means that you don't have to like paste in hex values or RGB values, whatever it is. It's just a really nice
workflow. Super handy when you have to source from real world reference.
Yeah.
And then the last one we have, this is quite a handy one, and this kind of makes one of our old tutorials a little bit obsolete. So one of the features they just added is they added planar projection into the fill layers. So let's just make this a color, and let's drag and drop our nice little friendly F logo.
So if you ever wanted to know how to make a logo, I guess you're watching this video already, so it's kind of irrelevant. But don't watch the old video where we make a logo, because it's obsolete now.
This is way better. So we are now just dragging and dropping our FlippedNormals logo into our logo slot. And then under projection, we now have two new fancy options. We have spherical, which is quite handy for certain things, but where this is handy is planar project. This means that we can now use the gizmo to scale up our logo and move it exactly where we want it to be. And there we go. Now we have our nice little logo right there. So what you got to keep in mind here, you have to disable repeat because we don't want our logo everywhere. We want to win certain places. So the cool thing about this is really that we can use all our gizmos. So we can just move it around and all that. We can also just scale it down as well here. If you want to, you see the fall off is quite smooth here. So we can just scale it down, or, you know, we can just disable repeat.
Yeah, I was into like, oh, then you could paint a mask. So like, oh yeah, disable repeat.
You just disable repeat.
There you go.
So this is so handy because now you can just move it around and it's fully procedural. So, you know, if you change your logo afterwards, you can just very quickly do it. This is incredibly handy for production because what you have a lot of times is you have so many graphics going around it.
Yeah.
Let's say you're doing a movie. Let's say in theory it's with giant robots, and these giant robots have logos on them. And then the client would change your mind about as to what logo there is, or something happens. Now you can just very quickly just replace this right away instead of baking it in. What we did before is we actually projected the image, which is also a totally valid approach. But the problem with that is that now you are stuck in that logo forever, and you can't change it. So really, really, really like this feature, the planar project feature. Super cool. Really like these new enhancements.
Yeah, there's a lot of them coming out for Painter nowadays, and they're really optimizing the software. So it gets more and more fun and easier to use every time, I think.
Yeah, it really does. Some of my personal favorites of one of these is, I mean, it sounds like such a simple one, but this
it's clicking.
Exactly, like displacement mapping, that is one of the sexy heavy features which takes ages to develop and all that.
We were actually quite surprised. Like, we tried running it on your laptop, and even on a laptop, it ran pretty smoothly.
No problems. All you notice performances.
So like right now, we're running it on our 980 Ti, and
pretty beefy boy.
Yeah, and you know that obviously, I think that's going to be able to. Well, it is going to be able to run more heavy stuff. But for quite complex things, you can even run that on a laptop, which I think is pretty impressive.
Yeah, it's so cool. I just want to do it again. Super cool.
Yeah, and you can use this for a bunch of different things. Like, we have a video that we're going to be producing, which is where you can create details, you know, have clothing from Marvelous Designer and how to detail it in Substance Painter. And originally the plan for that was to only include having it as a like a bump map in Substance Painter, but with this feature, you know, you can pull in your maps and, you know, have height maps for it, and then actually have really nice fabric details within Painter.
Yeah, we really, really like this.
Yeah.
So yeah, these are the five features you probably didn't know in Substance Painter. If you have any of these cool features yourself, and you're screaming at the video now being like, I already knew all these, but what about this feature? Tell us, and we'll make a video about that as well.
Because we don't know everything.
We really don't know everything, and Painter has so many nice little hidden things as well.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we really hope you like this video. And if you want to see more videos like this in the future, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and hit the notification bell as well to get notified every time we put out a new video.
So thanks for watching.